agility by Z-Man, and you saw Flamingo pull the hair. Referee apparently did not get a good look at it. Fans, I've just been informed that Jake Roberts will be accompanied by a reptile. Consequently, I will not be doing that interview. So I hope that they can find Cactus Jack, or Jake can interview himself. Flamingo again pulls a hair and regains the advantage into the head scissor. Referee's asking him to pull the hair. Obviously, he's not going to admit it. Wrestling, like in any other sport, officials can't call what they don't see. It certainly is frustrating for many of us as we watch, but it's a thankless job that these officials do. And they do an outstanding job for WCW. Working in the NFL this year with the Falcons, I've seen a lot of bad calls in the National Football League. So it can happen in any field of athletic competition. Flamingo just coming with right hands, and Z-Man's retaliating. And right back to the side headlock. Good sound fundamentals by the Z-Man. As I mentioned, he grew up in Minneapolis. WCW very, very excited about being back in great state of Minnesota 1 week from today, 3 o'clock in Rochester and 8 o'clock in the St. Paul Civic Center. Flamingo got the knee in. The pace quickened and Flamingo able to react. He buried the knee into the abdomen of the Z-Man and measures the elbow, but Z-Man is so quick. And back up to the side headlock and another takedown. And again, Flamingo's pull the hair. This has got to be extremely, extremely frustrating for the Z-Man, who is out wrestling Flamingo, but Flamingo's breaking the rules, taking the shortcuts. Irish whip chest first into that turnbuckle, and a great suplex. Flamingo folds him up like an accordion there. And now Scotty Flamingo back with the advantage. We thought it would be a very high-spirited and a very competitive contest, and that's exactly what we're seeing. Nice wide base as Flamingo has that hole cinched up on the arm, putting a great deal of pressure there on the elbow and the shoulder. Working on the arm now, the Z-Man. Man still to come. Tony Schiavone up close with Eric Watts. The Vegas connection is here. Cactus Jack will talk to Jake Roberts and his and friends, so to speak. And Tony Atlas, certainly a familiar name to longtime TBS fans, returning to WCW. We don't know exactly his motivation, but we do know that he is associated with Cactus Jack. And that should be enough said right there to let us know perhaps Tony Atlas' intentions. As the Z-Man and the Flamingo back up to vertical base. Flamingo, nice drop toe, back working on the arm. Really has the Z-Man grounded from that preferred high-flying aerial offense that he likes to execute. Mingo trying to get a submission victory here. We've already had two submission victories in our broadcast thus far here today. And we're certainly happy that you're with us, wherever you may be watching our broadcast. Z-Man comes back with that forearm, finding its mark on the chest of Scotty Flamingo. Now the knee to the solar plexus, and another one. Irish at far side, nobody there. Nobody there that time. And can Flamingo capitalize? Lateral press, he got two, and that's it this time. Back to work on the arm and shoulder of the Z-Man. Z-Man, in the early going, seemed to want to wrestle a very fast-paced, offensive-minded contest, but Flamingo has countered that with a more methodical style. Both men attempting, obviously, to dictate the pace here in this matchup. And both these men so competitive, so evenly matched, quite frankly, that perhaps it's the first man to make a big mistake here that's going to lose this contest, as Flamingo got another unfair advantage by using the ropes for additional leverage. He is a very, very cagey competitor from West Palm Beach, Florida. And he must have been a pickpocket or something in another life. He is able to bend the rules and hide it from the referee. I guess there's an art to that. You can hear the crowd chanting for the Z-Man. It's exciting here at center stage. Flamingo with a knee to the midsection now. And there's a snap suplex. This could be all. He charged the vertebrae of the Z-Man. He hooked the leg, but got two. Z-Man able to kick out. And he goes right back to work on the shoulder.